The first Monday of every month, we answer your Facebook medical questions. Dr. David Foster with Island Family Medicine joins us now with some answers to those questions, sir. It's a pleasure having you on. This is new for you. You haven't had a chance to really do this with us yet. But Kenny here says, why am I thirsty all the time, especially at night?
That's a very common symptom, and it can be anything from just as simple as just to being overheated or a little bit of mild heat exhaustion to something even more complicated like maybe diabetes. I mean, being extra thirsty, drinking extra water, those are common initial symptoms of diabetes.
Can it have anything to do with sodium intake? If we're eating lots of chips or lots of, I don't want to say sweets, but things with a lot of salt in them.
Yeah, salt and sugar drinks too. They tend to dehydrate you. Your body to absorb that extra salt, extra sugar, has to use up some of its water stores to absorb all that sugar.
Okay, and let's go over to Sarah right now. She says, hyperthyroidism, why is it solely common with women? How can we get our mates, family, to understand and be more supportive of who has it?
Well, some diseases are linked genetically to our sex, and some are linked within family. We talked about diabetes. A lot of us know that diabetes runs in families. Well, hypothyroidism does as well, and it does happen to be more common in women. The thyroid is a gland that is, we call it a master hormone. It helps direct all the other hormones. And so depression, fatigue, the symptoms for hypothyroidism are wide ranging and can be debilitating.
And it's one of those, if you suspect that, go see your doctor.
Absolutely, we have very good treatments for it. So.
Okay, let's see, we have Rosemary. She says, what should you do to keep high blood pressure down, and do you have to take medicine for it?
Well, that's a great question. You do not have to take medicine for high blood pressure. In fact, we hope that with lifestyle changes that you can control it without medications. Of course, we talked about diet and exercise earlier. You and Kristen were talking about that. Limiting salt intake, limiting alcohol intake. Sometimes those simple things can control high blood pressure.
And so a matter of just getting on a good workout routine, start eating the right foods, and get going from there.
Exactly right. It's a great start.
Okay, and we have Crystal. She says, can you have ovarian cysts removed if you have PCOS? Explain what PCOS is.
PCOS is an acronym. Medical field loves our acronyms. Polycystic ovary syndrome, and it's where the ovaries are non-functioning. A normal ovary produces one cyst every month during a cycle. Polycystic ovary, the cysts tend to remain and they build up over time. Unfortunately, the ovary is a very small gland, and if you have a lot of cysts, you can't take them all out without removing the whole ovary. So not all of them can be removed.
We have about 30 seconds if we can dig in deeper if
sure.
You want to go for this. Okay,
go for
so
it.
Let's see, Todd says, what are some of the things you can do to ease pain during a gallbladder attack?
Once the attack has happened, it's pretty much the cat's out of the bag at that point. There's not much you can do to reduce pain, except take pain medications or have the gallbladder removed, ideally.
Okay, and last question. Fidencio says, my friend says it burns when he goes to the bathroom. Is this kidney stones?
It could be kidney stones or a simple infection.
Okay, easy as that. It was a matter of going to the doctor and finding out.
That one would have to be, we'd have to do a little more investigation there.
Okay, Dr. Foster, always a pleasure having you come in, sir. Thank you very much for being here with us.
Thank you.
Okay.